Hi, this is Kate from Izzalicious Designs. Well, last year I made a pumpkin in time for Halloween. Well, this year I thought I would do something a little bit different and we'll make him have a little jack-o'-lantern face. And I thought I'd show you how to do that. It's pretty easy. And I think probably once you get the hang of how we do the lines and how we line these up, you will find it a cinch. So let's get started. We're going to do a magic ring, and we're going to start with a magic ring of 6. You can do it on your hook, or you can use your loom. If you are going to use your loom, and I'm going to zoom in a bit. As I said, it's going to be 6. I'm using the Rainbow Loom Neon Bands, the neon orange, for this. So I've got 6 little bands here that I'm going to do my magic ring with, and 1 that I'm going to wrap around the hook, the peg, I should say, of my loom, like so. I didn't use the neon orange for this one, I used the opaque orange, but I'm a little bit out of opaque orange, so I thought I would do it a different shade. Poke your hook through and draw back your first band and one over the other. Please, if you have not familiarised yourself with the Loomigurumi stitches, have a look at my beginner's guide to Loomigurumi. I also have a playlist with tips and tricks for Loomigurumi with all the different stitches, including how to make a magic ring. I had an extremely rude comment from somebody yesterday about not showing them closely enough how to do the magic ring, when in fact on the particular video they were talking about, I'd zoomed right in and gave links on where they could go to find out exactly how to do it nice and slowly and up close, and I've ended up having to ban them from my channel because they were just so obnoxious. So here we are, there's a magic ring. As I said, I will put the link up for you to get to the playlist if you need it. Budge these around so that they're evenly spaced. You are going to need a stitch marker of sorts, so here we have a little stitch marker. Now, this is not your first stitch here, this is your first stitch right here. And we're going to go around and we're going to do an increase in each of these. But in our first one, as we pull it back through and do our single crochet, we're going to put our stitch marker on. Just like that. So that was our first single crochet in that first stitch. Let's do a second single crochet in that stitch, because that then means it's an increase. And we will then increase the diameter here of this little magic ring from 6 to 12. In our second stitch, we'll do our first single crochet and go back through and do a second. In the third stitch, 1 and 2. 1 and 2. And our last stitch here. 1 and 2. Our next round, we're going to do a single crochet followed by an increase. So, let's move our stitch marker out of the way. Single crochet followed by an increase in the second stitch. Single crochet. Oopsie. And an increase in the next one. And that is the pattern until we get round again to our stitch marker. you should have now gone from 12 stitches to 18. Next round is going to be two single crochets followed by an increase. That was one, two, and an increase. One. And always check, you can always just pull it apart and have a check where you're at if you need to. This will take you to 24 stitches. Now we're going to do three single crochets followed by an increase. This will take you to a total of 30 stitches. We're going to do a single round, so one round of single crochet. Okay. Move your stitch marker onto the first stitch. All right, back to the beginning. I'm going to go through the first stitch and put my stitch marker on so that it's holding my stitch. Okay, and now we're going to get some black bands and we're going to work out exactly where we want to start putting our black bands for our mouth. It's very well to say it's on the 10th stitch and this, that and the other, but it's nice to actually map it out, and I do that by using little marker bands so that we're not having to count the whole way. So we count at first and put our marker bands on, and then as we crochet up to them we know where to change colour. So I've got some black bands and I'm going to count. This is number one that actually has my stitch marker on it. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So this is where I'm going to put my first black band as my little marker band. Okay, and that's where I start doing my change of colour. So I'm going to pop my hook through and we will single crochet up to that point. With orange. When we get to this black stitch, we're going to do a slip stitch. So we have the black band here. We're going to take one half off and slip our orange band onto it, our little orange loop onto it, and do a slip stitch. We're going to use another black band and do, and that's a nasty one, I'll get rid of that, and do a single crochet. The next stitch is going to be a slip stitch with the orange band. So through the loop, through the stitch, add your black loop to it and do your slip stitch. We're going to do another orange, just a regular single crochet. In your next stitch we're going to do a black slip stitch, so black band through, add your loop to it, slip stitch. The next two stitches are going to be black single crochet, just regular single crochet, then you'll do an orange slip stitch. So pull through, add your back black loop, do your slip stitch. I'm going to do another single crochet, a black slip stitch. So we've gone 2, 3, 2 for your black. Another black band in a single crochet, switch to orange again, slip stitch, and do orange all the way around to your stitch marker. So where you start a new colour, you do a slip stitch, okay? And back to my beginning, I'm going to do my single crochet and move my stitch marker, like so. See how we've got 2, 3, 2. So again we're going to go round until we get to those black bands. We're going to go around with orange, and then with our black bands we don't need to do 2, 3, 2, we're just going to do a whole line of black bands, but I'll tell you where we start that black line. So cozy. This is my last orange stitch here. I'm going to go through that orange stitch with the black band and do a slip stitch. Now if you have a look here, you can see there's a slip stitch here. That is not part of our stitch. That is the slip. This is the stitch here. Okay, so we go through that, not the little one that's angled, and we're doing a single crochet, and in the next one a single crochet, and then you can see that orange one here is at an angle. That is the slip. So you go through the one next to it, and we're just doing this in black, not having to change color. The next one is a regular single crochet, so we just do that. Again, you can see this is the slip stitch where we changed color, so you go through the next one to it, which is the actual stitch, just in black. The next one is fine. Just do a single crochet. The next one is fine because we did three black stitches there, if you remember. And then we come up to a slip stitch again. Again, you can see it's at an angle, so we go, and it's at the color change. So we go to the next orange, and we're still using our black bands. Single crochet. This one is a single crochet. Then we have the color change where we've moved to black, and you can see that is at an angle. It's a slip. So we go through the next one. This is the actual stitch. Single crochet. And this one is a single crochet as well. And then we have a slip stitch. See here. We're going to go through the next. We don't go through the slip stitch. We go through the next, which is the orange. And we're going to change to orange. And because we're doing a color change, we're doing a slip stitch. And that is how we are doing the mouth, like that. We're going to do orange all the way around till we get to the stitch marker. So at the stitch marker, I'm going to go through the first stitch so I can move my stitch marker. There we go. Put that there. Now, I want to look here. This is where I'm going to put my nose. Now, I'm going to do an entire round of orange before I do my nose. But my nose is going to go in the middle. See how I've got the two, the three, and the two. It's going to go in the middle. So we're going to do an entire round of just orange. And in fact, I've done two entire rounds of orange. So we'll do two entire rounds of orange, and then we will start doing our nose. So I will meet you back at the stitch marker when we've done two rounds of orange. Let me just add before we do that, as we have the change of colour here, this one is the normal stitch. And then this is the slip stitch. It's at an angle. We go into the black stitch next to it. Just doing single crochets. And the same after, at the end, you'll have a slip stitch at the end of the black in orange where we did the color change. And again, you miss the angled little stitch that's the slip stitch and go into the next stitch, which is the actual stitch. We'll just get there in a second. Didn't want to leave you on your own just for that little bit. It wouldn't really hurt. I mean, pumpkins aren't a regular size, so it doesn't matter. It would just add a stitch where you don't really need to. So here we go. This is our second to last black stitch. Our last black stitch. Then can you see this is our slip stitch here where it's at the angle and it's going between the black and the orange, so we go through the one next to it. So I'll catch you back. We've got to get to the stitch marker and do another round of just orange. I'm back. Hopefully you are too. All right, as I mentioned, we're going to go in the middle here. So if you look, this is the band that we want to be in. If we want to be in the middle of our teeth, this is where we're going to do the center of our nose. Now, if you will notice, the nose is three along. So when we do this, we're going to start one before this marker band and one after the marker band. But this is just a visual indicator for us to know that we're going to be changing colour. So let's do our oranges until we get to one before that black marker band. Let's not drop my bands. Let's have a look at what we have here. So we want to start in this one here. So we've got one more of orange to do. And then we're going to go black here. So remember, we're changing colour. So we have to do a slip stitch. So black through, add your orange loop, do your slip stitch. Now we do a normal black single crochet and another black single crochet in the next stitch. And then we change back to orange. So go through and we've got to do a slip stitch because it's a change in colour. So add your little black loop to it. Drop all your bands. Come on, do this properly, Kate. Slip stitch, there we go. And around we go with orange until we get back to our stitch marker and do our next one. Now with our next round, again, we're just going to be doing single crochet until we get to the black part of the nose. And we're going to go from three stitches for the nose up to two, because we're going to try and make a little triangle. Sitting here thinking round and round the circle, or is it round and round the garden like a teddy bear? One step, two step, tickling under there. Did you used to sing that to your kids, or did you have a mum and dad that sang that to you when you were little? We used to do that with Izzy, but I feel like I'm going round and round the garden doing these rounds. Alright, I'm nearly back to the beginning. I'm going to put my stitch marker on my next stitch here to indicate that that's where I started. There we go. Let's go around. Now I am going to go in to that last orange stitch that I have, because remember we had three here, which is one, two, three. So this is my last orange stitch. I'm going into that, and this is then my slip stitch here, which I'm ignoring, and I'm going to go into my next stitch, which is here. All right. Now if I did a slip stitch in black here, do you see? It's going to bring it in just slightly, which is what we want to do. And then we'll do a black stitch like that. And then this is another slip stitch. I've got a broken band. Let's get rid of that. Another slip stitch for the orange. See how that's going in? And then this is a slip stitch here in the orange. You're going to ignore that because that's the color change from the row below. So you're going into this one here with orange. See? Like this. And we'll go all the way around again until we get to our stitch marker, just doing single crochets. Now, I am going to be speeding things up a little bit so that we don't take forever. Back to the beginning, single crochet, move your stitch marker. Now we're going to do a single black one in the middle here, so let's again go around. You're going to go through your last orange stitch, which is this one, with an orange band. There's your slip stitch in black. Skip that and go to the next black band stitch. You're doing a slip stitch because we're changing color like that. But we're going to this one here, the next black stitch, you're going to go through and change color to orange. And you're doing, again, a slip stitch because you're changing colour. Here we have the slip stitch where we change colour from the previous round, so you go through the one next to it. And that's how we did the triangle for the nose. Again, let's go around until we get to our stitch marker. So let's go around for our next one, and this time we're going to add some, let me move my stitch marker onto this first stitch, we're going to add some eyes. I want to move my stitch marker first and then we'll place out where we want our eyes. Now, in my original one I did a row, or a round I should say, before doing my eyes. I think I would actually prefer to have my eyes a little bit lower, so I'm going to do them now. And what I'm going to do is you count three from the top of the nose. So 1, 2, 3. I'm going to pop my hook here and put my marker band like that. And then the other side, don't count your slip stitch. 1, 2, 3. And pop your other marker band like that. Now we'll go around doing yellow, doing orange until we get to our marker bands. And for the eyes, I'm going to start the triangle with the point down. So with just one black band, and then the next round is two, and the next round is three. So this is my black band here. I'm going to just unravel it a bit. It's a colour change, so we have to do a slip stitch. Oops, let's undo all our stitches first. Or let's not, but I did. So pull your loop through, add your orange loop to it, slip stitch. And then again, we're going into orange straight away, so you have to do another slip stitch. And then we do orange, avoiding the slip stitch that we have here in the black. This is a slip stitch, this is not. Because where you have the colour change from the orange to the black, that's the slip stitch. And then if you look here, we've got black to orange, so this orange is the slip stitch, so we go into this one. It's a bit finickety, I know. Another orange. Now this is where we do our next eye. Again, it's a slip stitch. And now because we're changing to orange again, we have to do another slip stitch. Okay, and then we keep going round until we get to our stitch marker. And around we go again. Move your stitch marker to your new first stitch. And this time we start our colour change one before the black band, because we're going to be doing two. Remember, look out for your colour change with the slip stitch. So, this is where I have my original black one. I'm going to go through this orange one, and with a black band, do my slip stitch. This is a slip stitch here on the round below, so I'm going through my black one here. And again, I'm going to do my second single crochet in black. This is a slip stitch, so I go through the next one, which is orange, and do a slip stitch because I'm changing colour. See, that's how it's going to look. Let's go around till we get to the next one. And again, the one before, we do our slip stitch with black, miss that little slip stitch and go into the black stitch, do a single crochet, and then we're slip stitching again, but we're avoiding that one, going in here, and we're slip stitching again to change colour. And again, all the way around with orange until you get to your stitch marker. Oops, one band at a time, Kate. through your first stitch here, change your stitch marking spot, and around we go again. And again, for this one, we're going to go a stitch prior to the black band. Oopsie. So here we're going to change colour with our last orange, slip stitch with a black, skip that slip stitch, go into your first black stitch, single crochet, the next one, single crochet, the next one is orange. Skip the slip stitch and go into the orange stitch. Oh, and do a slip stitch. I nearly forgot myself. There we go. And around we go to the next. And again, if we look here, this is our last stitch. So that's what we're going to do a black one in. So in through this last orange, do a slip stitch with your black, skip the slip stitch there, go into the black, single crochet, the next one is a single crochet, and then we go orange again, missing this one, and doing a slip stitch. So there we have the eyes. Let's go all the way around to our stitch marker. I'll meet you there. So I'm back to the beginning. I've gone through my first stitch. I've pushed my stitch marker on. I'm now going to do an entire round of single crochet only in the orange. But we have to remember, where there is a colour change in the row before, we're going to have slip stitches to manoeuvre through, if you remember. So here we go, this is our last yellow, but then next to it is the slip stitch of the black. See it? It's at an angle, so we go through this one here. And just keep doing single crochets. And then there's the change here, the colour change from black to orange. And you can see that little orange slip stitch, so we go in here, ignore the little slip stitch. Oopsie. I've had a lot of people asking me about when I'm going to do my Elsa dress. I promise I will now that Izzy's back at school. But it's just, there's only so many hours in the day. I can't get all the ideas in my head done as quickly as I want them to be done. Again, here's our slip stitch where you've got the colour change. So go through the next one. You ignore that little slip stitch. We've got one more to ignore. Oops, go through both loops. See that little orange where we colour change from black to orange? That first little one at the angle is the slip stitch, so go through the one next to it. So that is our first round of single crochet in orange. Our next round we're going to do three single crochets followed by a decrease, and we're going to do the invisible decrease. Now I know when you do it with crochet you do the decrease, I believe, on the inside. We are doing ours on the outside. It looks better in Loomigurumi if we do it that way. If I was doing amigurumi, which is with yarn, I would actually be working on the wrong side here. And I'll show you the difference. I'm going to just get here and go through my first stitch with my, move my stitch marker so it doesn't fall off. And then I'm going to show you why, as a Loomigurumi person, we prefer to work with this side. So as you can, I'm just stitching it, marking it here, pop that there. So as you can see, this side, it looks quite good, where we have all the little knots to make the shape. If you turn it the other way, this is the little, the side with the little V's. I don't think that looks nearly as good. You have these little bits that pop out and it just doesn't look the same, which is why for Loomigurumi, we do work this way, because it just looks nicer with the little knots this side. Okay, that's a perfect example to show you. All right, so as I said, we're doing three single crochets followed by a decrease, and then you do two and a decrease, one and a decrease, and then we do decrease, but we are going to be changing colors. So let's do one. Oh my goodness, come on, fumble fingers. Two, three, and a decrease. So you're going through the outside loop only of those two stitches. Single band, draw them together like so, and then count another three single crochets. One, two, three, and a decrease. So the first outside loop and the second outside loop, and pull together. One, two, three, two, three, one, two, three, through both, one, two, three, and our last decrease. So our next round is going to be two single crochets and a decrease. So go one, move your stitch marker, two, and a decrease. One, two, and a decrease. Two, and a decrease. Oopsie, let's try that one again. Oh my goodness, come on. Ah, runaway bands.
Get on here.
Where was I? That was a decrease. So this is 1, 2, and a decrease. We're now going to do 1 and a decrease, okay? But what we're going to do, yeah, we'll do 1 and a decrease. So here we go, 1 and a decrease. I was going to say we'll stuff it, but no, we'll do our 1 and a decrease first and then we'll stuff. Oops, make sure I don't skip a stitch, that would be bad, leave a big hole. And we finish on a decrease here. I am going to do a single crochet just to get into my first stitch and to move my stitch marker. And then I'm going to pop my stitch marker just down here so that I can get my stuffing. And we'll stuff this and then we'll close it off. So I've got my stuffing. Let's do this. Push it all down. And you can make it as full as you like. Not as full as you like, depending on what you prefer. I would be careful about stuffing too much. If you do stuff it too much, you tend to find that these stitches will pull apart and you'll see the stuffing inside. And that is a huge indicator to you that, ooh, I should probably take a little bit of this stuffing out. It's a little bit too jam-packed in there. So, you don't want it to be too squidgy and not have enough stuffing, but in the same instance, you don't want to see all that stuffing. You want it to be the stitches and not stretched apart. So I think that one actually looks a little better with the eyes closer to the nose, I have to say. So we're going to close this off and we're going to do this little knobbly stalk bit on the end. I'm using brown. For the next round, I'm just going to actually do single crochet in brown. So this first one, we need to do a colour change. So it's going to be a slip stitch. Like that. And then we're just doing a single crochet in brown. Oops, come on you. Try pushing the stuffing down so you don't get it tangled in with your loom band. Now, this is the slip stitch that we went through. What we're going to do next is go through the post. So the post is where, instead of this is the stitch that you would normally go through the stitch like this, we're going to go behind the stitch and then come up through the stitch, the front of the other stitch, like this. All right, and we'll do a single crochet, and then again, so through the front of the stitch and up through the back of it. Now, if you're finding this difficult to do, on my Loomigurumi tips and tricks, I have a video going very slowly and clearly how to do this. But you're basically working in the post. I will link it here so that you can see exactly what I'm talking about and find it quickly and easily, so you can go and have a look if you need to. So we're working in the post. And this makes it sort of stick up so that we can actually work on our stalk. Now, if you do want to put your stitch marker back on, you can, because we're just going to be doing little decreases around the round that we've made here. So we're going through that first stitch and we'll do a normal single crochet and we'll put our stitch marker on. Now what I'm going to do is do a decrease. And then a single. And we're just trying to grow this up a little bit while still making it smaller. And a decrease. And a single. And a decrease. And a single. I can see that I've got an odd one here, so I'm just going to do a single. I want this to grow up a little more, okay, because that's not really very knobbly here. So I'm just going to do a round of single crochet, which is one, move my stitch marker. Two. You might not have eight. I do have eight, but you might have less. Now I'm just going to decrease until we can close it all off together. So this one will be a decrease. And this one will be a decrease. It gets fiddly. And a decrease here. And I think we can fit one more decrease in here. If I can squeeze it, I don't know if I can squeeze it out there or not. Let's try one more. One. We can, and now I'm going to go through the opposite side of where I am with a single band, pull through and do a slip stitch, pull it nice and tight. Now I want this end of my band to be tucked in to the knobbly stalk. So I'm going to go through and pull this back in like so. And then as I let this back out, that will sit inside. Now there's not stuffing in that. It doesn't really matter. But I think it's really cute. So there you go. That's how I made my little jack-o'-lanterns. I'm going to have those decorating my mantelpiece for this Halloween. Do them all sorts of different colours. Have fun with them. Take care. Bye.